all the time. And she never has to run. She gets 100% of the vote, whatever they're doing. But she's always moving. I mean, you never see her stopping. And so everybody knows the tremendous contributions that are made. And I was called a representative because she's going to get that vote in the East Fund District of Columbia. That was a home to nothing.
Earlier, the very important change was mentioned, the disparity between sentencing for crack cocaine and powder cocaine has already been reduced. The hearing that was held yesterday, whether or not to make that retroactive, it probably will become retroactive. That means that thousands of these young people are soon going to hit the street. That's why this bill is just on time to not have been said. Danny's bill is no magic bullet. It's one of the most modest because we pass grant programs, states have to apply for them, you've got to compete for them. What is it, $191 million? I hate to compare that to what the budget is this year. But what it does do is to begin to equalize federal responsibility not only for extortion when they come out, but to the communities they will come home to that are ready to reintegrate them, but need help from the Congress in doing so. We are very grateful for the Second Chance Act to Danny and Chris and all of those who helped us get this far. I think it's very important.
When I was in Oakland, California, it felt like I was in the sticks. I mean, there was so much activity going on that Barbara Lee had inspired, motivated, stimulated, activated, until if I could have, I would have just picked up my belongings and moved down to Oakland so that I could be the beneficiary of all of that energy that takes place all the time. Barbara Lee had, when Ron Dellums was leaving Congress and people were wondering what was going to happen, but the people in Oakland already knew that Barbara Lee would happen. Representative Barbara Lee.
I want to congratulate Congresswoman Philip Patrick, the Congressional Black Caucus, all of our sponsors and those who have been working so hard for so many years to finally get this Second Chance Act passed. Again, the timing couldn't be more appropriate, but to see what you have done, Danny, toiling in the wilderness, oftentimes the lone voice in the wilderness, staying, as others have said, staying with it, being very focused, not being deterred, understanding that what the goal was and not losing sight of that goal. I think it's a real testament to how, first of all, this democracy can work, but also a testament to your commitment to formerly incarcerated individuals, those of whom are oftentimes forgotten. So thank you very much, Danny Davis, for giving us the opportunity to co-sponsor this bill and for being part of this effort. I do come from Oakland, California, the Bay Area, and of course, Danny visited when we went to San Quentin. He talked and he saw about 1,000 formerly incarcerated individuals come to a meeting where we proceeded with the process of remedying their records. Now we have completed over 3,500 remedies of the records, and now these individuals have a second chance. But with this bill now, these individuals whose records have been remedied now will have the real support that's necessary once the Senate and hopefully the President signs the bill, will have the support that's required to move forward with their lives. We have an organization, and I think this summarizes how I feel today and how I felt about this bill. It's called All of Us or None of Us. And that's exactly what this is about, All of Us or None of Us. Congresswoman Norton mentioned the benefits to the community. Well, we all recognize and know that recidivism is sometimes 60, 70, 80%. But by providing the type of support that's necessary, this will definitely reduce the recidivism rate, increase public safety, not to mention the help for families and for formerly incarcerated individuals to move forward with their lives. And so this is a very important day